What's going on, guys? It's Wafers, and welcome back to the Newport County Road to Glory Career Mode. It's episode 34, and today we are going to be finishing up the January transfer window and heading into the first couple of games in February. But before we get to that, let's take a look at the league table. Coming into this episode, we are in fourth place, level on points with Preston North End, on 49 points in 28 games, 3 points ahead of Millwall, and 8 points ahead of Bristol City, who are in seventh, and we will be facing them in the final match of this episode. Before we get into any games, though, we get an offer for Miguel Aziz, and we will be declining that. We also get an offer for Dom Telford, two players that I'm not looking to sell right now, so we will decline both of those and see if what we can do as we head into this game at Carrow Road, visiting Norwich City. They would come forward pretty early on with a nice passing move here, just working the ball around. Sometimes the CPU can be pretty difficult to defend on ultimate, and they end up going up 1-0 off the back of that nice passing. But a couple minutes before the half, we would come forward, Telford looking to make something happen, hits Coughlin, who finds Hopkins. Eventually, the ball ends up with Adam Rollins, and he's going to heel-to-heel left foot shot to get his first goal as a member of Newport County and tie the game up at one. A really nice goal from him, just some skill inside the box and a left-footed finish to bring us a level. 20 minutes after the restart, and we would come forward again, looking to take the lead this time. It's Shepherd down the right-hand side. He's going to cross this one in, and Bennett volleys it home to put us up 2-1 over Norwich City. A really nice goal there, a really nice cross by Shepherd, and Bennett is able to finish that one off. We come forward again, looking to get some insurance, and Lee Jenkins here is able to head this one home. A really interesting goal. He actually chests it down into the ground, and then he heads it because it bounces up right in front of him. That gives us a 3-1 lead. Norwich would come forward late on, looking for a consolation goal. They would get it. They cut it to 3-2, but that is how it would end. We pick up 3 points against Norwich City in the first game of this episode. After that game, we get another offer, this time for Marcelo Castellón, a player swap deal from Feyenoord, and we decide to decline that. Out of all the wingers I have, I'm not looking to sell him, at least right now, maybe next season, but I really like what he offers to our team off the bench. Into this QPR game, and the best chance in this game would come off of this corner win. Heads it, but the keeper makes a really good reaction save, and that was the only chance in the game, really. This one ends 0-0. I think our first 0-0 of the entire series. I can't remember another one. I usually either I score or the opponent scores. I don't have many 0-0 draws, but we do get one there. And heading into this game against Birmingham City, we were looking to get back on the scoreboard and pick up some more points, but they would come forward early, and Alan Halilovic scores really early on, and he was just killing me this game. We would try to get back into this one a couple minutes before the half. Bennett playing it to Marsh, who finds Telford. He slots it home, and we get level with Birmingham City. Heading into halftime, Halilovic was just a real problem this entire match, and he scores the goal for Birmingham City. No one scored in the second half, although there were a couple of good opportunities, and it's another draw, this time a 1-1 draw. Into transfer deadline day, and we get an offer for Harry Coughlin, who obviously we are not going to sell. We're going to reject that immediately. We also get an offer for Hopkins from AFC Bournemouth, who are looking to fight for one of those automatic promotion spots. They're currently in third, but they're looking to get back into second to get one of the automatic places. we also get another offer for Harry Coughlin and an offer for Lee Jenkins. So a lot of our young players actually getting some offers on this transfer deadline day. We're going to reject all of them and we are going to keep all of our players. As you can see here, we're going to take a look at some of the business done in the league. A couple teams making moves. Brighton sold £105 million worth of players, which is really interesting because they are top of the league. So I'm wondering if maybe that will bring them down a peg and might, you know, make it so the top of the championship is more wide open. Selling £105 million worth of players in the January transfer window means that their side got a lot weaker. So we'll have to see what happens. We'll have to see if they can stay in one of those automatic promotion spots or if maybe they're going to slip and fall as a result of selling a lot of their good players. But after transfer deadline day, we had some scouting reports to go through. Nothing out of England once again. England hasn't been this good, hasn't been that good this season, and I might look to spend some of our money at the end of the season on a scout for England, or I might just save it for next season. I'll have to see. As we keep going on, scouting will become less and less important as, you know, our players start to develop and really become first team quality and Premier League players. Into the scouting report for Wales, and we get another really good player here from Bryn Bowen. Ryan Griffith looks all right, but the real good one here is Connor Rees. He is worth £1.4 million. 80 to 94 potential, 16 years old, another really good find from Bryn Bowen out in Wales. That's a couple of good scouting reports now in a row from him. So we sign him up, and looking at the youth squad, this is what we're rocking with right now. We have some decent players. Tony Morgan's been there a long time. He looks decent. He's getting higher overall, and his potential is will be showing great potential. We also have some other good players here. A lot of the players with lower potentials I let go, but Connor Rees, 61 overall, center mid. I'm going to convert him to a cam. I think he'll go up a couple ratings as a cam. He doesn't really have defending stats, so we're going to put him more of in an attacking role. Jude Holmes is another good player here, 84 to 90 potential, 61 overall, and Prosser has the highest overall. He is showing great potential. We go into a game against Hull City now, our first game out of the transfer window, and we are headed to face them away from home, and they would come forward once again. The opposing team getting it started early in this one, a really lucky bounce there. Baker tries to clear it. It doesn't go away. It bounces off the Hull City striker, and their winger is able to score to make it 1-0. We come forward though, looking to respond, and here Marsh is going to dribble around. Then he's going to find Adam Rollins, who scores this one. And if you thought he was offsides, it looked like he was. I went back and checked it. It looked to me like he was offsides, but we get away with one right there, and we are able to tie it at one. In the 51st minute now, Hopkins coming forward is able to find Marsh eventually, who gets it to Rollins. Rollins is going to slot this one near post for another goal. He gets a brace in this one, and he puts us up 2-1 just on an absolute tear. After that first game where he didn't really do anything, didn't really get involved, ever since then he has been on fire. We have a nice last minute goal line clearance there to save the game off the post. Baker clears it, and we pick up the 3 points against bottom of the league, Hull City. We really need that win. That was a really important one to get the 3 points for. But our last game for this episode will be at the Rodney Parade hosting Bristol City. They're one of the teams fighting for a playoff berth, and we got the first goal in this one behind Adam Rollins once again on absolute fire. He is in form, the man in form, and he scores another one to give us a 1-0 lead. But Bristol City would come back, and off a deflection from Wynn, they collect the ball and they're able to put that one past Townsend with a nice shot to bring this to 1-1. A couple of minutes later, they would come forward again. Some nice work in the box here. They work it around eventually with some good passes. A little lucky here getting the clearance, but some nice skills. And then they finish it to go up 2-1. And we would have to wait all the way until the 70th minute for a chance to get back into this one. Telford tries to find Bennett. Eventually he does. And it goes back to Telford, who finds Rollins. Rollins is going to drive into the box, ball roll, push it past, and score another goal for Rollins. That is 5 goals in this episode, 5 goals in 5 games. And we get level again. We pick up a draw against Bristol City, which is a big point because we could not afford to lose that game. This is what the table looks like after 33 games. We have 58 points. Bristol City now into 6th with 54 points. Millwall with 53. That 1 point could prove to be very big as we come towards the last games of the championship season. But that is going to be it for this episode of the Newport County Road to Glory Career Mode. If you guys did enjoy it, make sure to drop a like on the video. Let me know what you think down below in the comments and subscribe if you're new, and I'll catch you guys soon with a new episode.